What is Starlink? It goes without saying that the internet has come a long way since its inception in the 1990s. The days when it took an hour just to load one JPEG are well behind us. The rapid growth and improvements seen within telecommunications are admirable. Yet, there's a whole lot more to come now that renowned venture capitalist Elon Musk has decided to dabble in the industry. Starlink. Elon Musk's billion-dollar project that'll take the internet to space. We'll talk about what Starlink is, why SpaceX plans to send 42,000 satellites by the end of this decade, and what this project signifies for the terrestrial internet infrastructure and the future of the online world in the years to come. But before we delve into the nitty-gritty of Starlink, let's examine the internet's infrastructure and how it connects to people around the world. This video that you're watching right now is in one of Google's many globally located data centers. If you were watching this video way back in the day, a geostationary satellite 22,000 miles away from Earth would be transmitting the video to your device. But communication via this satellite is painfully slow, and therefore doesn't see much use in this age. Today, this video is coming to your device directly from the data center, via optical fiber cables, an intricate network of cables consisting of thin glass wires that stretches underground across oceans, carrying data in the form of light signals over the world. The fiber doesn't directly connect to your streaming device. Instead, it connects to the internet provider's infrastructure that ultimately lets you connect to the internet via Wi-Fi or phone data. The problem is, this network of optical fibers falls short in reaching every remote location across the globe. As a result, over half of the world's population, mostly in rural areas, cannot access the internet. And this is precisely the problem SpaceX is trying to tackle. Elon Musk wants to bring the internet to the world's remotest regions with the project Starlink. The plan is to build a network of 42,000 satellites in outer space, between 200 to 400 miles above the Earth's surface. This means not only will they cover almost the entire surface of the planet, but they're also going to be 100 times much closer to the Earth's surface compared to the typical geostationary satellites. These satellites would communicate with each other via the same laser beam that our optical fibers carry, traveling much faster in space than the fiberglass on Earth. These satellites would provide the internet in the form of signals, like the geostationary satellite, except much faster and without the horrendous latency. The fast speed is owing to their shorter orbital distance and the fact that there will be 66 satellites providing internet access for each arbitrary plane on the Earth's surface. As of now, some 900 satellites are up in space, orbiting the Earth. SpaceX launched the first 60 satellites back in September of 2019, and the plan is to launch 60 satellites at a time. That'd send 12,000 satellites by 2024. To put into perspective how absolutely insane that number is, consider the fact that since the launch of Soviet Sputnik, there have only been 8,000 satellites put into space. Of course, the picture of our beloved home planet surrounded by tiny metal debris has raised some questions. How bad is Starlink going to contribute to space pollution? And the answer is, well, not a whole lot, actually. The satellites are equipped with propellers, meaning that if any of them were to malfunction, they would be drifted into space away from Earth. The propulsion system would also allow these satellites to reposition themselves whenever required to make way for space vehicles to be launched into space. One controversy is related to the lost and obscure hobby of stargazing, as these satellites are likely to cause a lot of light pollution once up there. The light pollution can actually pose serious difficulties to the astronomers because the satellites will be obstructing their views. I mean, there are only 900 satellites up there so far, and they've caused so many reports of sightings of these satellites. To alleviate this problem, SpaceX has made some efforts to cover the reflective surfaces of the Starlink satellites. Despite all these problems, it's easy to get on board the hype train for this amazing piece of technology. The coolest thing about Starlink is that it's not a competitive project. Its primary market is going to be in sparsely populated areas that have no internet access anyway. Because of the pre-existing terrestrial infrastructure, urban environments that use them would have little incentive to switch to Starlink. On top of that, Starlink isn't going to work nearly as well in cities because of the high density per plane in urban environments, which will require more intense use of the satellites above them. The terrestrial infrastructure isn't going to go anywhere because of Starlink. This is a kind of win-win for everybody involved. All of the world will get internet access, no matter where they're located, while SpaceX gets to take an estimated $50 billion market share per year, without trying to form a monopoly. Also, supporting Starlink is going to fund SpaceX's ambitious mission to colonize Mars. So, if you're planning to switch to Starlink eventually, think about the pride you'd be able to have in the fact that you'd be spending money to secure the future of mankind. Let us know in the comments what you think about Starlink, and if you think it's a good idea to have that many satellites up in space. Don't forget to subscribe to more tech-filled videos every week.